During daylight, the newly built M25 is a good, fast road. But at night, vast stretches of it are lit only by the lights of car headlamps. Safety campaigners say it's a hazard, and even the police agree that some of the accidents that have happened here could have been avoided.
We had one at the end of November where a heavy goods vehicle turned over and it blocked the hard shoulder and lane one, and other vehicles crashed into it. And I think that could have been avoided had there been street lighting. The chances are the approaching vehicles would have seen it.
The worst accident so far happened on the Surrey stretch in 1984. A multiple pile-up left 9 people dead. A report later said fog was mainly to blame, but the lack of lighting made bad conditions even worse. Only about a third of the M25 is currently lit, but now a solution could be at hand. The electrical giant Philips have offered to install lights along the remaining 80 miles of motorway at a cost of nearly £10 million.
We're making an offer. We're prepared to make an offer to the Department of Transport, basically to take away the problem of finding the money initially to light this motorway. What we're suggesting is that we will light it, and then we will charge them on a cost per annum per mile basis, so the capital cost doesn't become a problem of lighting this road.
It's an offer they hope the government won't refuse. So far, though, all the Department of the Environment are prepared to say is that they're considering it. But while the offer lies on the table, nobody disputes that more lighting is needed.